So months ago, I was talking about a product, the Professor Cobray's Light Scoop, as a way to get better onboard flash photos. At Canon especially, when you use that pop-up flash, the pictures are not spectacular. And that might even be a little bit too generous. They really just kind of are harsh because you're getting the flash is very close to the axis of the lens, so you get red eye, as you can see in this example here, and the light just isn't very flattering. So it's a well, you know, I found this thing. At the time, I think it was selling for about $20, and it slides into the hot shoe and slides into the hot shoe like so, and now your flash hits this and bounces back off the wall or the ceiling and then strikes your target. This is very similar to how I use a flash when we are photographing in professional settings. The flash goes on top and is angled backward and at an angle. So you can't recreate that angle so much here, but that gives much more pleasing and directional light that adds some nice catch lights up in somebody's eyes. So for example, if we switch to this image here, this is with the standard version of the light scoop. So they have a silver and a gold version. You can see that the red eye is gone. I have catch lights up in the top of the eye. Now, as I said, the benefit of having an external flash and angling it off is those catch lights would be in a corner of the eye, which is even better, more directional, more feeling. And then we have the standard version, or the actually warming version. I can't quite tell. Yeah, it's maybe a little warmer. Honestly, I'll be honest, I'm not sure which one is which. There's not a huge difference between the two, except something I'll get to in just a second. And that is that when you slide the warming one in here, works just fine. When you slide the standard silver version in here, the flash refuses to pop up. And the reason why, I don't know why they did this, or maybe the gold version came afterwards, but in the T5i, and there are other flash modifiers that have the same issue, including the Gary Fong Puffer, which I've tried. Terrible, terrible, total waste of time. They have a little piece of plastic that helps it sit in the hot shoe. But that little piece of plastic also triggers the camera to think that something's in the hot shoe, like a flash, and therefore the flash won't fire. The warming one, they have cut away, or made it without, would be a better way to say it, without that little piece of plastic. So, not long afterwards, I said, yeah, people get these. These are decent options. I'll talk a little bit more about that in a second. And a couple people picked up the silver and said, well, it doesn't work with my camera, and we've decided that you just need to modify that. And I've since picked up one of these guys, Dremel. So very exciting. And so I will be modifying this shortly, but you don't even need a Dremel. It's really just about a quarter of an inch of plastic that needs to be shaved away. And you could do it in a variety of different ways. A little file will get there eventually. It might be take some turns around the family. But don't hurt yourself when you do it. But then it works just fine. The question becomes, though, is it worth it? Because now I think this is selling for about 20, or sorry, about $30. And it certainly improves your images. You do have to adjust your flash exposure compensation up a little bit to adjust for that extra reach. Now you got to hit the ceiling and then fill the room. And I've shown how to do that in another video, and the link for that will be right down below. Your alternative for a TTL flash, a flash that can communicate with the camera, can adjust its exposure automatically. The cheapest one that I can recommend is the Yongnuo brand for about $80-$85. So about $50 more. And you can rotate that head. You can use it off the camera. So, you know, if you want to travel very light and you are finding yourself using the flash often in smaller rooms and you're on a very tight budget, okay, then maybe one of these is worthwhile. But if you have just a little bit more room in the budget and you want a little bit more flexibility, especially to grow as a photographer, then you should consider the Yongnuo. It's the 468-2, I believe. I'll put a link to the one I think you should buy right down below. And there are more expensive ones and more powerful that offer a lot of value for the money. People are very happy with these flashes. They don't quite have all of the bells and whistles of the Canon, although they pretty much do. The only real concern is kind of build quality. It doesn't seem like these things are going to last years, whereas the Canons often are built, or all the Canon models that I've ever worked with are built very well and last for quite some time. So these are called the Professor Cobray's Light Scoops. Buy the goldish one because there isn't really a whole lot of difference between the two of them if you don't want to do any modifications. If you are handy and for some reason you think the silver is going to give you much better results, just know that you're going to have to shave off a little piece of the plastic right there for it to work. Or consider an external flash that you can slide on and gives you a lot more flexibility. If you have any questions about light modifiers in general, very few of them work. Oh, I wanted to show you this very last picture. Was just holding a piece of folded paper in front of the camera. So there are a lot of do-it-yourself options out there as well. Index cards and rubber bands and popsicle sticks and paste and all those things that you like to eat as a little kid. You can do those, and they certainly will work. Sometimes you look a little goofy, and I certainly wouldn't walk into a professional setting with that because, well, they might not hire you again if you've got stuff paper taped and pasted to your camera. But they do the job for family functions and for taking pictures of babies. And of course, they are basically free and nothing really beats free. But if you're thinking about being serious as a photographer, you really want to explore the world of an external flash and the flexibility it gives you as a photographer. So if you've got questions about these, just leave a comment down below, or even better, take a moment and come on over to the Facebook page. I do a much better job of keeping up with questions and keeping track of who I've answered over there. Thanks so much for watching, and please subscribe. Thank you.